Welcome to Jikash Adventures. Today we are not making any recipe. Actually, we are making a recipe, but we are making a different kind of recipe. So today we are going to show you how to make a DIY pet friendly floor cleaner. So a lot of times we find pets actually having allergies to all the commercial floor cleaners that are available because there are a lot of chemicals in it, and you'll find your pet scratching their skin, or there are rashes on the stomach, or you'll find redness in the inner thighs and stuff. So that is actually due to the chemicals that are there in the commercially available floor cleaners. So here I'm going to show you a very safe and easy and very natural floor cleaner that we are going to make. And there are lots of containers and stuff that you can see, but it's very easy. It's a very easy process. So it is actually called bioenzymes. So if you read it up on Google, there are so many posts about it. And it is not only a floor cleaner, it is very good for sprays, like if you have bugs, mites, even to spray on the curtains and sofas and your carpets and stuff like that. It is very good, helpful and natural. So definitely try this, and I'll just show you how to go about it. The ratio we have to keep in mind. If we keep the ratio to the T, then it always helps. A little bit here and there is okay, but the ratio is actually 10 parts to 3 parts to 1 part. So 10 is to 3 is to 1. I'll just note it down here. So it is 10 is to 3 is to 1. That is all we have to keep in mind. 10 parts of water, 3 parts of fruit peels. So here we are going to use all the citrus peels. That is, I've collected some lemon, lime, oranges, sweet lime peels. So what I do is, as and when I use them in the kitchen, I just store all the peels in the freezer. So this is a lot of it actually that I've collected. And why citrus peels is because obviously the smell, the aroma is really nice, and it feels good to actually have a lime or a lemon flavored floor cleaner. So this is what you have to keep collecting once you use your lime and lemon peels and oranges and stuff like that in the kitchen. Just keep collecting. I'm again reusing the pet treat box that I have. So all the bioenzymes that I make, I usually make in these dabbas, so that I'm reusing the dabbas. And we need a airtight container, so this actually serves the purpose. And so fruit peels, 3 parts of fruit peels, 10 parts of water and 1 part of jaggery. So what is jaggery? This is jaggery that we have. That's it. So I'll just show you how to make the bioenzyme. So we need an empty dabba. The dabba should be airtight. And we are going to collect take 3 parts of the citrus peels. So this is about 300 grams we are going to collect. I am making 10 parts of water, that is, I am making for 1 liter of water. So for 1 liter of water, I will need 300 grams of citrus peels and 100 grams of jaggery. If you remember that, you will keep on adding if you want to make more. Like here I have made a big batch. This is almost like a 4 liter batch that I have made. This is from the September batch, 16 September. So always mark and tag whenever you actually make the whatever the date that you are making it. So it is easier to count, because we have to keep it like that for 3 months. So here now I'm going to take 300 grams of these citrus peels. Okay. That's $2.99. That's fine. And what I'll do is, I'll add all these pieces to the empty box. There's no need to thaw this because we've removed it from the refrigerator because it is going to be in the water anyways. And we need 100 grams of jaggery. That's exact 100 grams. I'm going to add this jaggery to this. And 1 liter of water. So this is 1000 ml. That is 1 liter of water. I'm going to add to this. So whatever dabba you take, just make sure that there is enough space left at the top. Because what happens is the yeast formation happens and then gases are released every day. So this is a natural process. So it is going to form, the cleaner is going to form on its own. So what happens is gases are released every day. So just make sure that there is enough space so that the gases can be released. Now just mix it all well. So just mix this all well and close the lid airtight. And as I said before, just mark the date, like today is this on 5th of November, and we'll put it in a place where there is no direct sunlight or where there is not much of handling happen to this. So put it in a safe place away from sunlight and in a cooler place. And I'm going to show you, I'll just put this all aside so we have space here. So Chika and Ash are wondering if some recipe is going to be cooked today, but this is not a edible recipe. My cooking partners. So here I'll show you what all I have. So this is actually my floor cleaner. It's almost over now. I'll show you how I make this. This I've marked of the 10 July. Now what happens is every day we have to open this, since the gases will be formed, we have to open this to let the gases release every day for about a month. And after a month you can open it say once in 2-3 days or once in a week is also fine. So you just have to open it for about 5 seconds, let the gases release, and just put the try and press the peels, whatever peels have come on top, just try and press it down. That's all you have to do. So I'll just show you. I have this bioenzyme here from 16 September. So I had made 2 batches actually. So this white thing on the top, don't worry about it. This is going to happen. This is yeast formation. This is actually going to help the process of making bioenzyme. So this is actually a good thing. Don't worry if there is a lot of white material that has come on top. So this will be ready after 3 months. So it will be ready on 16th December. So till that, what I did was, for a month I just opened it every day and let the gases release, and now the gas formation is not so much. So I open it once in a week or so and just press all the peels down. This is how the liquid looks like. Once after 3 months, when the liquid is done, what you have to do is you just have to strain it and then remove the liquid aside. The liquid looks like this. It's a proper liquid, and whatever remains, whatever the pulpy thing that remains, that I've collected. This is from my previous batch. So the pulpy thing that remains, this you can use for as a floor clean, as a toilet cleaner. So this is the pulpy thing. You can use it as it is, or you can dilute it and use it in your toilet cleaners, your bathroom cleaners. And the smell is amazing, of course. And we are doing a natural thing and not helping chemicals go down our drain. So this is actually a good thing to use for as a toilet cleaner. And to make the floor cleaner, what I do is I usually add this liquid. So you can do half and half. You can actually use the liquid as it is, or dilute it, or you can mix it with soap nut water like I do normally. So this is soap nut water that I make. These are the soap nuts. So these are soap nuts. These are available in any Ayurvedic shop near you, or these are available online also. So this is like my gold that I keep saying, because I use soap nut water in anything and everything, to wash utensils, for to wash my clothes, and add it to the floor cleaner. So what I do is I just boil soap nuts in water, and this gives a nice soapy, because they are called soap nuts, obviously this gives a nice soapy liquid. And I add this to the floor cleaner, I mean to my bioenzyme. So we are not adding any detergent powder or anything as such. This is all natural and safe for the pets. And I usually add white vinegar. So if you want more aroma and flavor and stuff like that, you can add lemongrass, you can add leaves, you can add essences, oils like neem oil, eucalyptus oil. All these are very pet safe and pet friendly and natural things that you can add to this. But I love the citrusy smell of bioenzyme, so I normally don't add anything else. So that's it, and just mix it all well, and your pet safe, pet friendly DIY floor cleaner is ready. So usually in about a bucket of water, I add like 2 tablespoons of this, like a one dhakkan, so 2 tablespoons of this liquid. And you will no more have pets scratching their body and stuff like that. There's another thing that you can do. Like here I have tried neem bioenzyme. This is the first time I have tried it. So this actually is known for if you have ticks and fleas and stuff like that at your home, in dog's bed and you know stuff like that. Because we run a boarding, we have to be very safe and very particular about all these things, and it's our home, so we are very careful. So again, the process is similar. These are all neem leaves, and there's jaggery and there's water, and the process is you'll see a white yeast formation on top. And now the first time you're making, just add 10:3:1 ratio. Now the second time you're making a bioenzyme, what you can do is this old pulpy thing, this bioenzyme, you can add one part of this to your new bioenzyme. So this one is what we've made just now, what I showed you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add about 100 grams of this pulpy thing to the, so my old bioenzyme comes here. This actually enhances the process. And if you don't want to wait for 3 months, if you just want to fasten the process and do it in a month, what you can do is you can add yeast granules, about 5 to 6 yeast granules per liter of water to this. So then the process is like fastened and it is ready in a month. So that's about it. This is our new pet friendly natural. I always go for natural things and I absolutely swear by this floor cleaner. So please give it a try and let us know if it has worked for you. And please do like and share this with as many pet parents so they can benefit it. And do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. And bye bye from our partners who are all asleep now.